Acura is returning the RDX to its turbocharged, super-handling roots and gifting it a buff, good-looking new body and a snazzy interior with an all-new infotainment system controlled by a touchpad. It's all part of Operation Make Acura Not Boring Again, a term we just made up for the brand's attempt to create a more focused lineup with sexier appeal than in the recent past. The NSX supercar was the first example of turning a new leaf. The RDX will be the first volume product to pick up the torch. Because every new vehicle redesign seemingly must incorporate a size increase, the RDX grows relative to its predecessor. Acura hasn't released all the dimensions for this prototype, let alone the production model, but tells us the crossover's wheelbase is 2.5 inches longer. That would place it on the large side for the compact luxury class, and Acura promises that backseat space and cargo volume will be class-leading. We poked and prodded and sat in the rear seat of the prototype for ourselves, and although roomy, it doesn't seem to live up to those claims. Final judgment will have to wait for Acura's release of the final product. More exciting than dimensional minutiae is the way the new RDX looks. As the first Acura vehicle designed from the outset around the brand's new pentagonal grille design, the RDX wears it best. Other styling cues picked up from Acura's precision concept from 2016 also work well, including the bold fender bulges, spur-like hood creases, and pointed headlights and taillights. It all combines to form a shape that is both sporty and upscale. Acura has packaged similarly appealing hardware beneath this canvas. A turbocharged 2.0-liter inline-four engine mates to a new 10-speed automatic transmission, the two items borrowed from Honda's excellent, of late, parts bin. Output figures still are forthcoming, but in the Accord sedan, this engine makes 252 horsepower and 273 pounds-ft of torque. Those numbers would place the RDX in the thick of its four-cylinder competitors such as BMW's X3 xDrive 30i, Audi's Q5 2.0T, and Mercedes-Benz's GLC 300. While the outgoing RDX's V6 produced more power, 279 ponies, it made less torque, 252 pounds-ft, and had only 6 forward gears to work with. We anticipate the new RDX will handily out-accelerate its predecessor, which ran to 60 mph in 6.2 seconds. Acura could go higher still and install the 306 horsepower version of Honda's turbocharged 2.0-liter engine that powers the Civic Type R at some point in the future.